12 kg kettlebell, dark blue kettlebell. We have to bring you in deeper into your stretch, not like exercise. So. And a 12 kg kettlebell.
Down and then back to the shoelace.
the knee as far over the toes as possible. And again, you can set those hips down. So see the way I've got my hips close to the heels? You can go hips high if you prefer. For me, hold the position for 2 minutes, I go hips low. If you go bang more to the ankle, take yours, he goes, yeah, it's like shoelace, yeah. And then try that now. Yeah, it's a bit better.
No, yours is really flexible.
Okay, so we've got 60 seconds. So again, we can apply that movement. You can go like a circular motion. Clockwise, anti-clockwise, you can just move forward and back. Stretch, pull harder.
hand, and you'll feel that deep calf stretch there. Okay? So the closer you can get the heel to the ring, the tighter you can get the heel to the ring. When you move the hip close, you're going to feel that deep calf stretch. You'll also find a wee bit of dorsiflexion in the ankle there. Drive it.
Leg lift, which is going to engage the
hip flexors and the lower abdominals. So we'll lie back, we'll go right or left, it doesn't matter which. So lower back pushed in, relax the shoulders in contact with the mat. Gain here, I'll double up to get more tension. You're trying to get this right leg as straight as possible. All right, we'll start to think of the opposite leg. So the leg that's not attached to the band, if we elevate that heel fist distance off the floor and point the toes. From here, once we hold this stretch, if we lift the opposite leg towards the ceiling, bring the feet beside one another, and then control back down toward the floor. Okay. We're going to cycle through for 40 seconds to elevate, control down, and point the toes. So you'll feel the squeeze to the hip as you lift that opposite leg to the ceiling. On the leg that's attached to the band. Nice and slow.
Back goes, thoracic spine, then
reps going. Again, slow, tuck chin, round shoulders. Those hips go back.
That's it.
attached to the band. That's the knee that contacts the mat.
Moving on to the left hip and bringing that top leg over.
at 90 degrees, we look to settle in that position. And then that bottom heel, you want to lift up and collect if you can. Once collected, just relax down. You'll feel a stretch through the front of that bottom leg, and you'll feel rotation through the lower back. Very similar to the 1990, yes, that's that 90 degree angle in the top leg. And then probably once you get that, the quad stretch, it'll just be beyond the 90.
You pulling your foot up towards your back?
Yeah.
Is it on the crown here over to the other side?
Yeah, on your left side.
Position.
flat yourself down.
Yeah.
And then pull over if you prefer. So if you're struggling in the quadruped position, just lie down, press the hips to the floor and pull. If you can, stay a wee bit higher. Attach to the shoulder if you'd prefer. Foot toward the ceiling. Find more from that stretch. The higher you can get that knee, the more of a quad stretch you will feel. We take hold, you can go high kneel in position first to find the stability and then drop forward. We elevate, sole of foot to the ceiling and pull tight. Away from you. ears. And from here, the hand that's furthest away from the rig comes up and over. We want the bicep right beside the ears, that overhand grip. Okay, and we let that hip drop toward the middle of the room. So find that nice separation. contact with the band. Just palms face you. You'll turn the palm away, grasp that band with the fingers and thumb. Turn around, elbow nice and high. And you want to finish with the bicep right to the ear. The top hand as low as you can, right to the backs of the shoulders. And that slight lean forward. You want to create a nice squeeze to the tricep. You might get a bit of a squeeze to the shoulder line as well. If you can't feel that stretch, all you'll do is you'll readjust, you'll drop the knot down a wee bit lower, and that's going to give you more resistance. So the lower that knot, the more resistance you're going to have. Try and stand nice and tall with this one. And the key is not to fight against that band, just relax that top arm and let it pull you deeper into the stretch that we would complete again on the program itself. Front squat that we completed, I think it was this week in our program, we completed the front squat. If you struggle with the front squat, it's because you struggle with external rotation. This will help you get the elbows high. When you're dropping into that front squat, you've got to keep the elbows high. You're going to fall forward and put pressure through your lower back. And I'm sure that front squat, you felt a lot of pressure coming through the wrists. Again, this will allow you to keep the high elbows and take away some of that pressure from the wrist and get more into that exercise. Gentle release. Okay, so we're going to go back to our purple band. So we just leave that blue band hanging off the ring. We're going to hook the purple band at the top. Okay, we feed through the knot. We pull tight. So we're going to go for that stretch here. I'll demo the movement first and then you can bring it in. So again, we grasp the band in the same way. So wrist sets in, palm faces you, grasp on with your fingers and thumbs. From there, you'll step back, okay? You're gonna sink the hips to the back of the room. From here, I can feel that band open me out already and I feel that stretch running down the right side of my body. And what I try to do in this position is create that arc. I'm driving the rib cage out towards the side of the room. So my right hand is on, so I'm pushing the right side of the body towards the window to get more from that stretch. So again, you'll be pushing toward the wall, that's it. side the band is on, toward the side of the room. Breathing's nice and simple, one of the simplest forms of breathing. Again, if you struggle with sleeping at night, sometimes if I'm like having had a stressful day and I have a wee app on my phone, it's called Breathe. It just brings you through box breathing. It's definitely great for helping you have a good night's sleep. So we're gonna go right 2 or 3 minutes. So basically it's breathe in for 5, hold for 5, exhale for 5, hold for 5. Okay, so we're just getting nice and heavy on the mat. If we extend the limbs, hands either side, legs nice and long. And let's just relax into this. Just take a couple of normal deep breaths. Big deep breath in. Long, slow exhale. Okay, so I want you to breathe in for 5 seconds. Hold. Long, slow exhale. Emptying out the lungs. Hold. Deep, slow inhale. Hold. Long, slow exhale. Hold. Inhale. Exhale. Hold. Inhale. exhale.
Feedback, any questions, I'd be glad to hear it. So we're going to keep the Tuesday stretch, much more program focused, some banded exercises, some